She is battered, bruised, scarred, smited by the hand of her husband's use, or the man that she wants to be forever, abuse. Consumed by whatever frustrates the mental mind of the masculine energy within this man that you can consider a punk. Blunt in his nature, taking this anguish of anger out on his queen. She is suppressed. She is submitted to these great pains of power above her flesh. She says, "I love you." One strike to the face, next. He caresses her body. Then he knocks her between two chairs to rest. The best sleep that she has ever gotten was a concussion, beaten and criticized to nothing. Chiseled down to something that she was not purposely trying to go into, but only falling in between the verge of finding love. She is misused and torn and dragged through the entire house. Eye, face, mouth, lost, pushed out of cars, 66 routes. Spontaneous, slashed across the face in a car in the driver's seat. She feels it coming. She sees the anger and frustration in his face. She's just waiting on the anticipation of when his hand and her face shall meet. Being used to it. Being keen to knowing when it's time for a beating of today. Wondering in her own mind, can this man hear her thoughts? Slap subconsciously for what she feels about this weak boy that she calls a husband, a boyfriend, a male friend, or man. She feels that she has to stay there, unable, wobbling, legs weak, can't stand, unable to demand, "Why are you beating me? You didn't see it at the altar wearing your beautiful dress, seeing him clean and pressed down to the bottom of his dress shoes with the grooms and the bridesmaids. But as soon as you were there, you were torn down to nothing, down to traveling towards his fist, his kick, his boot. He comes in from work drunk, mad, angry, lost his job, laid off, losing all of his loot, taking it out on you. Some have children that have to watch this episode of scenes of outrageous beatings of pain and swelling of the eye. Sometimes you wishing you could take your life and die, but you can't even cry. The blood runs down your tear. My queen, it doesn't matter what people say. This is what it really means. Leave. You can escape. Be free from the anguish. Tyrannical times, waking up in the morning, your food, your breakfast, decorating the walls because he is anger. Dawnings, being more angrier than last mornings, mourning the day that you have ever met this man. Your high school sweetheart grow to be just like maybe his father, his grandfather, just to whip out your heart. You never seen it. Touch eye, scream, holler, cries, dragged and getting rug burns on the rug because he doesn't respect you. Every time that he lay his hands on you, all he does is reflect the pain that he's seen on his own mother. But sometimes it's just in him to be that way, just like any other. Sits around, keep constantly saying, "Baby, I'm sorry, I only do it because I love you, I won't do it again." To try to spin you another lie, put a fish on a hook, and keep you in a constant rotation and a spin. Slapped across the room, through five racks, through a den. Head punched through a glass, "Baby, I love you, we can win." Face, eyes, again, chin, breakdown, now she's in the hospital, trying to survive, trying to stay alive. People say there's a thin line between love and hate. When did they ever get to love to prove that that's what it is? Where's the thin line where it doesn't hurt? You don't have to stay. Being someone's, let alone not punching bag, a counterpart of a champion practicing on his next fight on your face. Look at you, look at you, look at you. And you say you still love this man. Sometimes it's hard for somebody to be a superhero to you. Because if I knock this man down, you will run to him. Why did you hit him? You will protect him before you protect yourself. Walk away.
Every single opportunity you have, you've been smacked in front of your friends. Your friends say, why do you stay with this man? She said, I don't know. He doesn't mean to. Constantly making up excuses for this foul man's way of living on your face. There was no excuse for any man to lay hands on a woman, let alone a woman enticing a man to hit her. This is not just one case. It's all. Why fall in love to be broken and constantly have to shovel your pieces together, soaping, crying every night, calling your mother on the phone, telling her the things that's going on and nobody there to protect you and play you that sad, sad, funny Valentine song. Death has become your motivation, but you're unable to detach yourself from the situation. You're used to being this way. Basically, the lovemaking that you are having, it feels like you're being raped by your own loved one. Because of all the abuse, you go numb. While you sitting there being embraced, and he feels like he's making love to you, sweating over you, belt buckles over the back bed, shackling, and you screaming in your mind, just make it stop. Hoping that the next time he hits you, that he would just take you out and just end it all instead of you doing it yourself. It's not worth it. Just leave. There is nothing there holding you there but you. You are free to go. There's people out here that will help you. That is not a man. That is not even a boy. That is vermin. And the best way to get rid of vermin is to allow it to eat itself. They are nothing without you. Because when a real man hits a man that hits a woman, which is creator, man is just the key. But the woman is the creator. She bakes the cake. Leave. Just leave. Because a man that hits a woman is afraid to hit a real man.